إخوة الإيمان، سأبدأ حديثي بأحجية، والأحجية باللغة العامية هي الحزورة. ما هي الصفة التي ذكرها الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن الكريم 20 مرة ووهبها إلى جميع أنبيائه ورسله ولمن شاء من خلقه؟ من حصل عليها حاز على خير كثير، ومن عاش بدونها تخبط في حياته ووقع. I'm going to start my khutbah with a riddle. What is that character? What's that quality that is mentioned in the Quran 20 times? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it as a gift to all his prophets and messengers and to whomever he chose from the rest of his creation, the rest of humans. Whosoever possesses this quality, then he possesses a great deal of goodness. And whosoever lives his life or her life without it is prone to fall and live a disastrous life. ما هي هذه الصفة؟ What is this quality? هذه الصفة هي الحكمة. This quality is none other than wisdom. Wisdom. And we know, and I mentioned this before, a few months ago, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had a job description of things that he needs to teach. And it started with the dua of Ibrahim and Ismail. رَبَّنَا وَبَعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ كَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا فِيكُمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْكُمْ يَتْلُوْ عَلَيْكُمْ آيَاتِنَا وَيُزَكِّيكُمْ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ هُوَ الَّذِي بَعَثَ فِي الْأُمِّيِّينَ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُو عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ These are the 4 ayat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed on different occasions that include, among other things, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through his life example, through his sunnah, to teach us how to live our lives with wisdom. Because life is difficult. And without wisdom, we are prone to make all kinds of mistakes. And this is very important. All prophets and messengers were given this hikmah, this wisdom. It was part of their character. وَإِذْ أَخَذَ اللَّهُ مِيثَاقَ النَّبِيِّينَ لَمَا آتَيْتُكُم مِّن كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ ثم جاءكم رسول مصدق لما معكم لتؤمنن به ولتنصرنه قال أأقررتم وأخذتم على ذلكم إصري قالوا أقررنا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in Surah Ali Imran, Surah number 3. And remember when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took an oath from all the prophets as per the book that we gave you to guide you, and the wisdom that we instilled in your lives. This is something that was given to all prophets, yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Baqarah, يُؤْتِي الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. As for us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses those that are going to be given this wisdom. يُؤْتِي الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. وَمَنْ يُؤْتَى الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا وَمَا يَتَّكَّرُ إِلَّا كُلُّ الْأَلْبَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives as a gift some people that quality of wisdom, and whosoever possesses this, takes it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he had possessed a great deal of goodness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in many, many other places, وَأَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَعَلَّمَكَ مَا لَمْ تَكُنْ تَعْلَمْ وَكَانَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ عَظِيمًا. In Surah An-Nisa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he has given you the book and the hikmah, the sunnah that we claim that we follow, so that whenever we face some difficult situations, I'm coming to the point, by the way, I know it's on everybody's mind, I'm coming to the point, but I wanted to start with the premise. I wanted to establish why we are falling, why we are making so many mistakes, why we are, or we have, reached this state of affairs that everyone is wondering and asking, what's going on? It's because we are living our lives without wisdom. Without wisdom. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقُمَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ أَلِشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Luqman, because we have given you wisdom. And wisdom is a great quality. You know what? Those who seek wisdom, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, will give it to them. But those who are content to live their lives on the surface, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let them live their lives on the surface. So I mentioned this now, and now to the theme of the khutbah. We still did not stop talking about what happened in Paris. But I want to warn us that we make a mistake, but it's our nature. We are human beings. We make a mistake that once something happens today, we forget about what happened yesterday. Now, nobody is talking about the massacre of Peshawar in Pakistan. It's old news. Nobody is talking about Sydney. It's old news. Nobody is talking about Boko Haram in Nigeria. It's old news. Nobody is talking about the underwear bomber who was about to kill about 200 people in the air. It's old news. Nobody is talking about the things that are happening on a daily basis in Syria, in Iraq, in Palestine. Gaza. Do you remember Gaza? No, we forgot. It's old news. More than 2,000 people massacred. Yet the one who championed that massacre was demonstrating in the front lines to object for a terrorism act that was committed against the norms of civilization. We tend to forget. Now, number one, and I'm trying to establish my point in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so that we do not lose track of where we want to get. Number one, please, let us not isolate events. These are all manifestations of the same problem. This is number one. What is happening in Paris is no different than what is happening in Nigeria or in Syria or in Iraq. It's all a phenomenon. That's number one. Number two. Please, brothers and sisters, do not confuse إنما المؤمنون إخوة with a crime being a crime. Many Muslims, because someone says لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله and goes and commits a crime, emotionally we start to feel that let us search for something to defend that crime. No. Number two, brothers and sisters, a crime is a crime, whether committed by a Muslim or a non-Muslim or an atheist, it doesn't matter. What was committed in Gaza is a mass massacre, is a state crime, and what was committed in Paris is a crime, and what was committed in Sydney is a crime. A crime is a crime, that's number two. And it doesn't matter. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. Believers are brothers. This is a different thing. When a brother is prepared to live by the hikmah, by the sunnah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, that he is my brother, she is my sister. But when we deviate, no. I've got to say it as it is. Number three. Let us ask ourselves, are we reacting as Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam would have reacted to the things that are happening? The answer is a big no. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam never would have revenged by killing someone who is mocking him or ridiculing him or saying whatever in whatever form. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that in the Qur'an. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَلَقَدِ اسْتُهْزِئَ بِرُسُلٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ فَحَاقَ بِالَّذِينَ سَخِرُوا مِنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. O Muhammad, many messengers. And now when we read from Surah Yasin, after I finish translating this, we would say it's not many. All messengers, all of them, were ridiculed. People made fun of them. People described them with awful things. Now, in modern times, there is a tool that was not present at the time of Quraysh. Had they been familiar with caricature, I'm sure they would have resorted to that. But they didn't have it. They used other tools, awful tools. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is comforting Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and telling him that many other prophets before you were ridiculed, but their ridicule came eventually against them. And now, we read in Surah Yasin, we read in Surah Al-Hijr the same, almost the same ayah, Ya hasratan ala al-ibad. ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون. When we say ما يأتيهم من رسول, it means never did they welcome or not welcome, receive a messenger without them making fun of. And in Surah Al-Hijr the same ayah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says إِنَّا كَفَيْنَاكَ الْمُسْتَهْزِئِينَ, meaning, leave those who mock you to us. We will take care of them. And actually, Sheikh Sha'rawi, may Allah have mercy on his soul, was once told about a book against Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that is making fun of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was asked, did you read that book? He said, no. And I don't want to read it. And I don't want to read it. And they asked him why. He said, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah An-Nisa, وَلَقَدْ نُزِّلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الْكِتَابِ أَنْ إِذَا سَمِعْتُمْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ يُكْفَرُ بِهَا وَيُسْتَهْزَأُ بِهَا فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعْهُمْ حَتَّى يَخُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ إِنَّكُمْ إِذًا مِثْلُهُمْ. إن الله جامع المنافقين والكافرين في جهنم جميعا. It's simple. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look at this, very simple. that if you happen to be sitting in a gathering, and then the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start to be ridiculed and made fun of, then simply excuse yourselves and wait until they stop doing that, then go back and sit with them. حَتَّى يَخُوبُ فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ. It's simple. It does not say boycott them. It does not say go and kill them to give them a lesson. It doesn't say that. It says stop sitting with them to give them a message that we do not accept that. That's number three. How would Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم would have reacted to these things? He would have reacted differently. I would like to say that there was a person by the name of Misbah ibn Uthatha. He was a relative of Hadrat Abi Bakr al-Siddiq. And he was the one who started the commotion referred to in history as Hadithat al-Ifk, spreading horrible rumors against the wife of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Aisha. He was spreading rumors against his relative, because he was a relative of Abu Bakr. May Allah be pleased with them. And he was the one who spread it and did awful things until his mother, the mother of Misbah, started to curse him. And that's how actually Aisha radiallahu anha came to know what is the problem. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam wouldn't tell her. Her mother wouldn't tell her father wouldn't tell her, and she became sick. But finally, while the mother of Misbah was in the company of Aisha, she was mumbling a curse against her son. And she said, Ya Khala, why are you cursing your own son? So she said, didn't you hear what he's been spreading against you? And that's how she came to know. Now, what a kind of painful wound in the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam after he discovered it was Misbah who was spreading that. Did he go and harm him? On the contrary, an ayah was revealed in the Quran enjoining upon Abu Bakr, may Allah be pleased with him, to be kind to Misbah and not to stop helping him. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam forgave him. And Misbah became a good Muslim whose behavior was reflected in what he did afterwards. You know, the likes of Umar ibn al-Khattab and Abu Sufyan and Khalid ibn al-Walid, all of whom in the beginning of their life wanted to finish Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They wanted nothing better than to kill him and get rid of him. We know what Umar ibn al-Khattab was doing before he accepted Islam. We know what Khalid ibn al-Walid was doing. We know what Abu Sufyan did. Yet, through the patience, through the good character, through taking the moral upper road that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam took, all of these people became good Muslims. And we know who they are. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Fussilat tells us exactly what to do. Told us exactly that a good deed followed by, or a bad deed followed by a good deed will erase it. And as a result, فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. ادفع بالتي هي أحسن. ادفع بالتي هي أحسن. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. Now imagine if Muslims were living their lives with wisdom, with hikmah. Imagine if we are still following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did I say imagine? Yes, I did. Wallahi, it's so painful to feel that we have lost, and ma'alish, this is number four or five. Maybe it's four. معلش, it's okay. Let us face it. We have lost most of what Islam is all about and just kept the shell. Just kept the shell, the name. We are defending a shell that we are living in. Nobody can say anything about Islam. But did we ever ask ourselves, what is the Islam we need? Is it the Islam where a husband who is divorcing his wife refuses to give her her mahar? And you would say, what does this have to do with what you're talking about? Because it's all part of the same package. A Muslim is a Muslim, but we are picking and choosing. There are many, dare I say, the majority of people who get into divorce. May Allah save us from this. They play games so that they end up not giving the mahar. We are living in Canada. Go and do whatever you can do. Yes, you are living in Canada, and you may be buried in Canada, but when you will be resurrected, you will be resurrected in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether you are living in Canada or you are living anywhere else, you will not hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet there are Muslims who even play games. They refuse to pay the right wage salary to an employee because they want to make more money while the employee is suffering and is forced to work because of the need. We know that there are many employees in Gaza, in Palestine, who have not been paid their salaries. And those who have the money are looking at them. And how are they living? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. Number four, and extended to number five. Number five is, please, we need to stand in front of a mirror. We need to look at ourselves. Let us stop blaming the others all the time. This is a phenomenon. We have lost it. We are praying, yes. We are fasting, yes. We are going to Hajj and Umrah, yes. We are giving zakat. I hesitate on this one. Because there are many Muslims who pray and who fast, but when it comes to zakat, there are many ways where we can really go in different circles. This is the Islam that we kept. Brothers and sisters, as long as we continue to live our Islam individually without a collective responsibility, there are many who are living their Islam as individuals. But we need to accept, I accept the responsibility that those two people or three or four who committed the crime in Paris and the one who committed the crime in Sydney, I share part of that responsibility because we were not able to establish the Islam that will prevent our young people from becoming the kind of time bombs that everyone is scared of. Number six, did we ever ask ourselves, why do they hate us? You know who asked that question many times before. But let us ask this question, why? Let me finish the first khutbah by saying this. The cartoonists know very little about Islam, if anything. They don't know anything about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They just wanted to go with the flow. So they did what they did because they don't know. They don't know. Now, those who responded without wisdom to T-double-O know nothing about Islam. Even though they may claim, but we are the students of it. You don't know anything about Islam. Because had you known what Islam is all about, you wouldn't have killed for what you saw. Because Rasulullah ﷺ did not teach us that. We need to live by the Quran and His Sunnah. Therefore, I do not blame the cartoonists. I blame us. I blame us. In the second khutbah, I will quickly, inshallah, revisit how the only solution is to revisit how we live our identity. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين من دعاء الله سبحانه وتعالى He will accept our دعاء آمين يا رب العالمين الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي My dear brothers and sisters, there is a dua in the Quran that if we realize where it is heading and what it means, we will get goosebumps because this dua seemingly has not been answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what we are asking from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that dua is happening in the opposite way to us. And this dua is, رَبَّنَا لَا تَجْعَلْنَا فِتْنَةً لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا رَبَّنَا لَا تَجْعَلْنَا فِتْنَةً لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا Oh Allah, do not make us a kind of fitna for those who reject our faith. Do not make us a cause of commotion, a cause of confusion, a cause for hatred, a cause for what is happening right now. We are now being a fitna. We turned into a fitna. This is what happened to us. Those who reject our faith are looking at us and they are saying, look at yourselves, look what you're doing. There isn't 2 or 3 days without something that is happening now. As the poet said, فَصِرْتُ إِذَا أَصَابَتْنِي سِهَامٌ تَكَسَّرَتِ النِّصَالُ عَلَى النِّصَالِ I became like him who has been attacked from every corner. So much so that with every other hit I'm receiving from a sword, its blade is broken on another blade that got stuck in me. So many things are happening. And as if we are looking now and saying, now it's almost 1 o'clock, what's gonna happen at 2 o'clock? What's gonna happen tomorrow? Who is going to do what? And I will give number 6 or 7, I lost count. What shall we do? What shall we do? Brothers and sisters, as difficult as it may seem, we need to make it incumbent upon every father or mother, every teacher, every imam, every da'iya, every person among us, to teach the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to our children. I turn, and inshallah, we talk, Sheikh Jamal and I, I turn to Sheikh Jamal and say, let us start at our center. Let us have a continuous workshop that I invite everyone to attend to teach the seerah in modern perspective, not only the seerah as a collection of stories, but fiqh al-seerah, the understanding of seerah. The reason we are making so many mistakes is that we don't understand the wisdom of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who came to teach us that wisdom through his sunnah. That's what it means. وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ The Qur'an وَالْحِكْمَةِ What is hikmah? It's his life. It's his sunnah. And tell me how many among us know the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We might have heard, yes, the name of Umar al-Khattab, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Yes, we heard the name of Aisha. But how can we live that legacy in our present day life? So inshallah, we need to have as a first step, a continuous workshop in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And yes, I almost forgot, because some of you, when asked about did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam kill anyone because he made fun of him, and those who have very limited knowledge of the seerah mentioned the name of Ka'b ibn Ashraf. And so that I do not leave any stone unturned, I would like to mention, do you know who Ka'b ibn Ashraf is? What did Ka'b ibn Ashraf do in Medina to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to the Muslims? Ka'b ibn Ashraf, even though he was a poet, and even though he wrote poetry that made fun of the privacy of Muslim women, and Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf did everything, every day he could, to kill Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kill the heads of the companions of the Muslim community, to destabilize Islam and Muslims from the base. It would be similar to someone who would come and have an attempt to kill a head of state, someone who tried to kill that president or that king or that, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was none of that. But he was the head of a new final way of life to humanity. And when he was ordered to be killed, it was because of his crimes, not because of his ridicule. And there are other things that are to be attached to Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf. Let us, inshallah, come back. Otherwise, we continue to go with the flow until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. And I may, inshallah, on another day, talk about something that we learn and teach our children as a story. Just remember it. The deluge and the flood at the time of Nuh alayhi salam. Just keep it in your mind until the time comes, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permits. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad, kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim, fil alameen innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana.